Hey dudes, welcome to Feed Me Vegan. I'm Chelsea.
I'm Sarah Noreen.
Oh, changing it up today.
Noreen.
Yeah, so she's Noreen. And today we have an awesome show for you. First, I want to tell you Feed Me Vegan is a project of the Animal Rights Coalition's Vegan University program. As part of Vegan University, we like to show vegan cooking as affordable, easy, super good, and also fun.
Yes, we try.
Fun. We have a lot of fun.
We try.
We've been dancing all morning on set while we get ready, so hopefully there'll be some outtakes at some point.
We're gonna give you reasons to dance.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah, I mean, we are reason to dance.
Yeah, pretty much.
And so we're filming a special holiday show for you guys today. Mm-hmm. We're doing holiday baking. So we've got a little something for the pie lovers mm-hmm. in the world and the cake lovers in the world. And if mm-hmm. you know me, you know that I don't believe in pie. Like, I don't care about it at all. Hashtag cake is better.
Hashtag yes.
What about you?
Cake is better. I am a cake person, for
okay.
sure. I do appreciate a good pie, though.
Ugh. Well, this pie is the only pie that I like. It's an apple pie with an almond crumble topping. Mm. And then the cake is a peppermint chocolate cake with some pretty awesome things
yes.
going on with it. So let's get started, shall we?
Yes. Let's
Let's show them. We were going to show them this thing that we won.
Yes. Yeah. Let's do that.
So, guys, we have this beautiful award that, don't look at my fingernails, they're real bad. but anyway, look at my cupcake tattoo. It's cute. This is our award that our crew won for best new show of 2016.
Yep.
It's real exciting.
So shout out to our crew. They're the best.
They're awesome. They
thank you guys so much.
Try to make us look real good.
Yes. And they succeed.
Well, you look good.
Yeah.
Anyway. So that's our award, and we love it. We're super excited about it.
Yes.
And we weren't the only new show of 2016. Mm-hmm. I had to clarify. We were not. There were others. So we won. So should we do cake or pie first?
Let's do
the cake.
Pie. Oh, okay.
Because the cake has to bake.
Sounds good.
Okay, cake is over here. So guys, we have here, I need these first.
Should not I that this?
You can if you want to. Okay, so for our cake, we have wet ingredients here, dry ingredients here. I'm gonna show you the cookbook that I base this cake on. Do you guys know Chef Chloe? She's amazing. She's one of my favorites. She has a chain of restaurants now that have just been blowing up in New York and mm-hmm. I don't know where else, maybe LA, but she's great. So we're using one of her cakes as a base, but we're gonna change it up a little bit. So shout out to Chef Chloe, because she's beautiful and amazing. And very young to be so successful, which is great. Okay, so 3 cups of flour going in the pool. Do you think we should be wearing aprons? I don't want to get my pretty dress dirty.
I mean,
whatever.
I think you'll be fine.
All right, baking cocoa. I pre-measured this special for you guys, so you don't have to watch me do that. And then 2 cups of sugar.
How much baking cocoa was that, Chels?
2/3 of a cup.
Got it.
2 cups of sugar. You guys, it's holiday baking. It's not real healthy, but it's not really supposed to be. Baking soda. Yeah? Yeah. And some salt in there too, just a little bit. Brings out the flavors in baking. Here you go, my love.
Mm-hmm.
I need a whisk. You want a whisk?
Yes.
Here, be a whisk. Whisk that up real nice. And so now we're gonna have our wet ingredients here. So we have a cup of vegetable oil. So you guys might be wondering, you don't see any eggs here, obviously, because this is Feed Me Vegan. But this cake doesn't use any kind of weird egg replacer. We're just, well, not that it's weird, but you know what I mean. This cake uses vinegar and baking soda.
Yes, so and a historical lesson on that.
Let's hear it.
Back, I heard this from my grandma, and the reason why she came up with, seems like all the grandmas have this cake recipe.
Wacky cake.
Yeah, wacky. And it was because back in the day, like during the Depression and stuff, you couldn't make a cake with real expensive ingredients because everybody was kind of poor. So they relied on vinegar.
Yeah.
And then it was a baking soda that's also the other active ingredient. Yeah. So.
Good times. There's all sorts of different flavors of wacky cake. There's like spice cake, white cake, lemon cake, chocolate cake.
You can do
it. It's super easy, you guys. All the ingredients you usually have around. Another secret ingredient to like amp up your chocolate cake a little bit is to use coffee instead mm-hmm. of water for the liquid. So we've got 2 cups of cold coffee here.
It adds that little something.
It's a little something. And like we need more coffee.
Yeah,
though.
Right.
We're not amped up enough this morning.
If you need to keep the party going,
yeah,
just feed people this cake.
Noreen and I always keep the party going.
Yes.
So then we're gonna do 2 extracts. We're doing vanilla and we're gonna do mint.
Mm.
So this is our little holiday twist on Chef Chloe's cake. We're doing mint in there because we want it to be, you know,
minty.
Festive.
Yeah.
Right, minty. How about real minty? There we go.
Is that the right answer? Minty.
Minty. Refreshing.
Yes.
Cakey.
Zesty.
Moist?
Yeah.
Sorry. Sorry to all the moist haters out there. A little sploosh of vanilla. That's a technical term. All right. So, how's that?
It's good.
Do you want to whisk this?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Noreen and I are just... What did we decide?
I'm excited
we were like
for the
teenage boys.
Yep.
I want to show them this while you're whisking that.
Yes.
So maybe you guys have seen these super cool beverages in your store, but all sorts of different nogs that you can enjoy with no dairy or egg. So this one is so delicious, as you can see. It's just a traditional nog. They also have, I couldn't find the peppermint one that we love. There's a chocolate peppermint one. Does
yeah.
So Delicious make that?
That one's my favorite. I think so.
And there's yeah. also, is there a pumpkin one too?
Yes.
Yeah.
So all sorts of different kinds of nogs.
Let's try it.
For your holiday needs.
I'm going to mix it with my coffee. Do you think that'll
oh,
be good?
Oh, yeah. Put some in mine, please.
Okay, you can dump that in here if it's all mixed.
Okay, it is all
mixed. If it's all
mixed. It's been mixed.
I like this. So we were thinking that you could put a little nip of rum or whiskey in here, and that'd be super good for your holiday parties.
If you're into that sort of thing.
And if you know us.
Yes, we are fans of that sort of thing.
But it's 9 o'clock in the morning here in Minneapolis, so.
5 o'clock somewhere, though.
That's
cheers
what they say.
To that.
Cheers. Okay.
Oh, that made it better.
That's good.
That
Don't
made
use
it
that. Use this. You know me. Bossy pants.
No, no. Please tell me what to do. I don't know what I'm doing.
There you go.
Thank you.
So, let me find our pie plate or our cake plates. I don't remember where I hid them. I got so good at hiding things to make it look tidy that I don't remember what I did with them. I really don't. Do you think I took them home? I didn't. They're in here somewhere.
Yes.
Let me just get up in your business here.
Nope, do it.
Okay.
All right.
And they're cute, because look, yellow and teal. Yeah?
Oh, yeah,
okay,
so
guys, so when you make cake, I always make cake. It's kind of my jam. And I used to make cakes, and they would stick to the pan. And there's nothing more infuriating than that. A lot of the recipes will say, you know, grease and flour, or spray it with cooking spray or whatever. Mm-hmm. All you need to do, make a circle with parchment paper, and put it in here on the bottom, and then spray it. And your cakes will come out every single time, I assure you. But we don't have any cooking spray, so we're gonna wing it. We'll see how it goes. That's good. You don't wanna overmix your cake.
Right.
So, shall we, ooh.
Yeah, see, that's why I thought the whisk
yeah,
might
you gotta
be
get
a better idea.
You gotta get on the bottom.
Okay.
You gotta get on the,
there's like chunks.
Do it better. Just do better. I should have really gotten a manicure before this show. One day we should get manicures after the show.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Okay.
Holiday manicures?
That's good. Let's dump.
Okay.
And then I'm going to have Noreen go dump this in the oven.
Yes.
While I show you guys how to make the frosting, because the frosting is really our whole reason for living today. And you'll agree when you see it, I think. I can never make them even. I'm never real good at this part.
You're doing perfectly.
Oh, thank you. I need encouragement and validation. All right, the oven is preheated to 350 degrees, so it's all ready for you.
Good
deal. Dump those bad boys in. Set the timer for 25 minutes. Okay, guys, now we're gonna do the frosting. This is real great. I'm gonna teach you a little trick. If you don't want to make frosting from scratch because you're in a time crunch or you just don't feel like it, almost all of these kind of jarred frostings are vegan. The only ones sometimes that aren't are like if it specifically says milk chocolate or something of that nature. So, oh, I'm trying to show you, but I'm bad at this. There we go. So this one is from Aldi. It's just chocolate frosting. It's vegan. Sometimes even the cream cheese ones are vegan, so that's pretty cool. So we're just going to do this, but we're going to doctor it up. And I think you'll like it. Okay. Frosting in here. And then I have right here in this bag a bunch of crushed up mint Oreos. So you can use mint Oreos or you can use the candy cane ones. You could use regular ones if you don't want it to be too minty since the cake has mint in it. But we're going all out today. And Oreos are vegan, guys. So that's pretty exciting. Not on purpose, but accidentally so, and that's good enough for me. Okay, so there's that. And now all we're going to do is take, I think this is about 2 cups, I would say. And some of it didn't get smashed. I just chopped them up in the food processor a little bit. But you could even, my mom used to do, just put them like this in the bag and smack them with a soup can. work out your aggression. So that's what's happening here. I'll save these for Noreen. And then, let me find a mixing implement. This'll do. Did you see what I did here? Yeah, dude.
My favorite things.
And you can use a hand mixer, that makes this a little bit easier, but I'm gonna let you just stir that frosting up for me while I get the pie ready.
Good deal.
So let's do pie, yeah? I'm gonna show you another trick about pie that maybe you guys don't know. Okay, so in this pie, we're gonna start with the crust, obviously. And just like we did with the frosting, we're taking a shortcut today. This pie crust, also from Aldi. Pillsbury is also vegan, but this one, vegan. What you wanna look out for in pie crust is lard, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
My mom always said lard makes the best pie crust, but I disagree, like pretty much completely, because this is good and it's fine. And I a lot of times will make my own pie crust, but you know, it's the holidays, everyone has a lot of cooking to do. So we're just gonna do it this way. So pie crust is gonna, hey, where's our, oh, there it is. All right, so that's what we'll do first. We'll put the pie crust in the thing. How does that look?
Mixed.
Do you wanna try it?
Do I wanna try it?
Yeah. Tell them if it's good.
Yep.
Does it need more mint? You could put some mint extract in there. Probably don't need to though, yeah.
That's perfect.
Okay, do you wanna get the cutting board out from under there and we can start washing our apples? Or I mean cutting our apples? We already washed them.
Where is the cutting board?
In the sink. Okay, so we just roll this out and I'm gonna try to make this a little bit pretty. I'm always really good at making food taste good, but sometimes it's hard to make it pretty. But we're gonna try our best. So this pie, like I mentioned, has a crumbly top because that's what I like. I don't really care about pie crust very much. But you could just make this with a, so what I'm gonna do, I don't know if you can see what I'm doing here, move this guy. But what I'm doing is I'm kind of just pinching around one of my fingers to make like a scalloped edge.
Where's the apples?
In the big white bowl. Right there.
Oh,
sorry.
Goodness gracious.
You know, I just hide things. So I'm trying to make this a little bit.
Do these need to be skinned?
Yes. Okay. And I have the, that is very sharp. On a previous episode, I cut my finger open peeling ginger. So be very careful.
Okay.
It's a real sharp vegetable.
I am accident prone.
You know, and sometimes I don't peel the apples when I make pie, but it's better if you do, I think, for this application. So we've got four Granny Smith apples. You can maybe even fit five in here. Does that look okay, do you think? I mean, it's not the prettiest ever, but.
Well, that looks good enough for me to eat.
Yeah, it'll
be
fine.
It's all going the same place, right?
Yeah, in your mouth.
In my mouth.
So that's what we're doing with this. Now we're gonna cut up our apples, but while she does that, I'm gonna measure the other ingredients for the filling. So what goes in here is, let's see. Ooh, so this is just all-purpose flour, guys. I'm gonna put a couple tablespoons in here.
Nothing fancy.
Nothing fancy. You could use whatever you
want,
though. You could use oat flour or whatever.
You can do whatever you want.
What have you. We're gonna put in some chopped pecans. I told you it was gonna be almond, but we're gonna make it pecans today. But you could use almonds, that's fine. And then I'm gonna use a bunch of brown sugar. A bunch meaning like 3/4 cup. No, wait. Yes. Yeah?
3/4?
I don't know, some. What we're doing with this is what we're coating our, you know what, I did this wrong. This is gonna be the topping, you guys. This is gonna be the crumble topping, not the middle, so sorry about that. I already dumped the pecans in, so this is the topping. Topping is flour, brown sugar, and
pecans
and melted
pecans.
Butter, melted earth balance butter.
Oh, yes.
I've also made it with coconut oil, which is good too. But we're using butter because why not? It's the holidays.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, and what else goes in here is a little bit of almond extract, which I don't know where it is. Do you know where it is?
You just hide
it's right
things
here.
Too well.
You're doing a good job there.
I'm trying.
Just a little zhuzh. If you guys don't know almond extract, it's real good. And it's my mom's favorite.
It's super strong.
It's pretty strong. Yeah. Smell that.
Oh, yeah.
It's my mom's favorite. We make fun of her because every single, all the time with the almond desserts. It's her most favorite, so. I think we need a little bit more flour in here. Because we want it to be like a crumble. You can also use granulated sugar for this, but brown sugar's prettier. How are we doing?
We're getting there. Just taking my time because I don't want to cut myself. This thing is very sharp, by the way.
What are you doing for the winter holidays?
Well, the one that's coming up right now is Thanksgiving. So I'm going to be with hopefully my family on Thanksgiving most of the day. What about you, Chels?
On Thanksgiving, I'm hosting. And then we also have a fun little thing coming up with Secret Santa gift exchange where we're doing a pizza party.
Yes.
Right? That's going to be fun. And then, so I like presents. I got my Secret Santa the present already, and it's going to be awesome. She's going to love it.
Yeah, me and Chelsea hang out outside the show because we actually like each other, unlike some co-hosts in the world.
What?
Just in general. haven't you heard about that? Like,
oh, yeah.
People in entertainment, like they actually hate each other.
We love each other.
Yeah.
And so we hang out, and we have other girlfriends with whom we hang out.
Yes.
So, okay, there's our topping, guys. Brown sugar, nuts, flour, delicious.
I go so far to say that you guys are my chosen family.
Aww. I'm going to show, that's Aki. Okay, I'm going to show them.
Okay, and then do I chop?
I'm going to show them how we like to, I'm going to put it over here so we can see it. No, you did great.
Peel those right? Okay.
You did great.
Good deal.
So we also want to core them a little bit. So what we're going to do is, this is how I do it. Mm-hmm. One, two, it's very exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, that's all.
Are you waiting with bated breath?
Kind of.
Can I have the big white bowl?
Yes.
This is where we're going to mix everything. So we're just going to kind of finely slice these into like so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Comme ça.
Yeah. Comme ci, comme ça. Okay. I'm sorry, this is probably kind of boring, you guys, but we're chopping apples. It's fun. So I can tell you what else we can do, Noreen.
What's that?
Do you want to put a tablespoon or so of that lemon juice in there?
Yes.
Give it a little citrusy kick, and it also keeps your apples from turning brown.
Exactly, I was just going to say.
Which is great.
Okay,
you could just dump some, like a tablespoon.
Yeah, there we go.
And then you can dump this in there. That's the rest of the flour. Actually, just a couple tablespoons in there. Just dump a little bit. It can't really mess it up that much.
Okay.
And then a bunch of cinnamon.
Good?
Yeah, that's probably good. And then we need a bunch of brown sugar. That's in this black crock over here. I like to call it a crock. Isn't it cool? Our old co-host Ryan gave that to me.
Okay, so how much?
I don't know, like...
Eyeball it?
Like half of what's left. Like 3/4 of a cup, I think, is what goes in there, maybe.
Okay. Like so?
Maybe a little more. I like your style.
Like so.
Like so. And I believe that's all. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna coat these apples with that yum, and then we're gonna put it in that pretty pie crust. Do you think it's pretty enough? It looks kind of wonky. Fix it.
You did a good job though.
So I know that your mom's vegan.
Yes.
What about
shout out to my mom.
Yeah, and she's stunning.
Oh, that's very nice.
But what about the rest of your family, your brothers and your dad?
They are not vegan. However, I have been invited to a holiday thing at my brother's on Friday, and I'm bringing pumpkin chocolate chip cookies.
Ooh.
And every time that I have brought vegan desserts to my brother's parties, where they pretty much just have drinks and stuff,
I like your brother.
Everybody eats my stuff. Before anything else. Like, everything else stays on the table, the meatballs, everything. Except my cookies are always gone.
So at your family gatherings, it's not all vegan?
No.
Okay.
But they always eat my crap first.
Good. I know, because it's delicious.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm lucky because for the last few years anyway, I've talked to my family. Like, I always host Thanksgiving, which I love to do because I'm a control freak. And I'm the best cook in the family, if I do say so myself. Don't tell my mother. I don't know if she watches. But so I host, and then I can tell people no stuff that's not vegan at my house. And so for the first couple years, my mom would bring like a little plate with foil over it of turkey. But this year I said, in the last couple years, I said, nope. You
not
can eat
happening.
Mine. I'm gonna make a seitan roast though.
Yum.
Yeah, dude.
Okay,
so this bowl is real big, so you probably can't really see this very well, but we're coating our apples with this delicious lemony brown sugar flour mixture. What do you think?
Looks great.
You look great.
A little bit more.
You look great.
I love us. We're so good for each other's egos.
It's true.
You're such a flirt.
That is also true.
That is also true.
Yeah, I
okay.
will not deny that.
All right, so let's arrange these in here a little bit, shall we?
Yes.
Oh, I mean, sorry. Sorry, Cheryl. Now Cheryl has to make a chicken sound to bleep that out. Sometimes it just. Oh, I wanted to tell you something that Zane said the other day.
Okay.
Zane is my 2-year-old. And he was looking around in the refrigerator because he's obsessed with opening the refrigerator. Oh my gosh, so annoying. But anyway, he opens it up and he goes, Mommy, where's the freaking milk?
Oh my God.
So I said, don't say that in front of your Nana. Because, you know, how's that? What do you think?
Excellent.
Okay.
Beautiful.
So there's that. And then let's... My hands are dirty.
I know.
Okay, so do you want to put the crumble on top of there?
Yes.
Okay, so here's that. Crumble that up on top of there. Oh, it looks so good. You don't have to be real precise. Look at that, you guys. Oh, my gosh.
Don't people want to see, though?
Mm-mm.
Me slowly.
That nog is so good.
I know, it made our cruddy coffee better.
Mm. Yeah, Noreen got us a soy peppermint latte thing this morning.
Not so much peppermint.
But no, it was not pepperminty. So I'm just gonna kind of put this all around. Look at how delicious that looks, you guys, and it's not even cooked yet. So I wanna show you the difference because with this one we use the brown sugar on the top, but in the one that's in the oven right now, well, let's properly reveal.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys ready for this? Are you pumped? And we have the cutest little container. Okay, are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Well, I was born ready.
So you can see the difference between using white sugar and using brown sugar. So when that cooks, it's going to be a lot more, you know, darker and more brownier.
Mm-hmm.
Brownier, but yeah. So we have pie. And...
Oh, yes. I'm supposed to talk about this. Okay, so this is...
You had one job!
There, yeah, I know. And I failed. This is fun. So this is soy whip, and I also saw in the co-op that I was just in to buy this, they had rice whip,
if you want,
that sort of thing. Yeah, you also told me to get a thing called cocoa whip,
Awesome. So cocoa whip comes in like a Cool Whip container, and it's made of coconut milk, which you can make that yourself too, but... There's a few different things available. And this is a very tricky apparatus here.
Yes, it is.
Every single time we've tried to use this, like camping for waffles or anything, it always breaks. So you have to read the instructions and follow them.
And shake the crap out of it.
Shake the crap out of it.
Mm-hmm.
So do that. And
do it
then
in.
I'm gonna get out our cake because, oh, we have one already ready.
That's true. We should just cover the cake with this too.
Cover everything with whipped cream.
Pull pan upside down and press square shape button down to
defeat. Why did I make a wedding song?
I don't know.
Okay, guys, peppermint cake. So what we did is once those cakes are done, you let them cool all the way. And then you take that delicious Oreo frosting we made and slather it in the middle and on top. You can do the sides too if you want, but it's kind of like chunky because of the Oreos, so I don't.
Gosh.
Did you break it?
No, I just, you know.
Put it in your mouth. Yeah. I love our show. And so then I took a bunch of candy canes and red glitter and ground it all up and put it on the top. And then it made a heart because we love each other.
It's true. We do love each other.
So, you know, do your own holiday baking. It's fun.
Ah.
You know, that's not bad.
It really isn't.
Okay.
This stuff is actually pretty darn good.
do your own holiday baking, guys, or go buy your vegan pies and stuff at Whole Foods. That's fine, too. But try these. They're really fun. And you saw pretty easy. So if you want the recipes, they're going to be on the YouTube video link at the Animal Rights Coalition's YouTube. Just scroll down under the video to the description, and you'll see all the recipes and the products that we mentioned today. What else?
Have a good
follow holiday. Us.
Yeah. Yes, follow us. I'm Minnesota Vegan on Facebook and on Instagram now, and we also have an
Feed
Instagram.
Me Vegan.
Yep, we also have an Instagram for Feed Me Vegan now, so you get to see pictures of us doing things. Have a good holiday season, guys.
Oh, and send us, if you follow Feed Me Vegan on Facebook, send us ideas for what you'd like to see us make on the show. Any favorite recipes you have that might not be vegan that you miss, mm-hmm. we'd love to feature them on the show. Just write in if you have ideas for guests you'd like us to try to have on.
Absolutely.
Send them our way. We're happy to take suggestions and probably not criticism, though we might cry. Probably not.
We're sensitive.
But anyway, do some baking. Have fun, guys.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
Oh, what was it, the Pee Wee Herman? What was the other one? I want more of this.
Yeah.
That was a lot. Give me a... Oh, did I do it?
And yeah. Oh. For love.
Aww. Almost got chocolate all over
it. It's all good.
That's a good looking cake right there.
This is what happens when you make a vegan a vegan pie. Everybody's happy. He's got a nose too.
Oh yeah. Yeah, he does. He should have a tongue.